Wisdom is a principal thing. Therefore get wisdom. With all that getting, get understanding. But where shall wisdom be found? And where is the place of understanding? Man knoweth not the price thereof, neither is it found in the land of the living. This is the other school of destiny, where we are committed to build your hope and the dealings of wisdom and understanding for life pursuit and fulfillment in destiny. Listen and be blessed.
Thank you for joining me again. This is the second audio. So let's get back to business. So you see people jumping up and down. They don't even have a direction for their life. So sit down where God wants you to be. Pray and look for where God wants you to be and sit there. Sit there. Sit there. Everything man will eat and become is inside the man and the environment. I will show you from the scripture. Stop looking for what to be up and down. See, omission in life and destiny is the foundation of life of frustration and misery. When you omit this, frustration will set in and misery will set in. Do you understand? When people neglect the laws and the principle and the ordinances of God, they become blind. They become blind. But if you are ready to learn and unlearn, there's a way out. That is what we come to give. In the book of Ecclesiastes 10 verse 15, the Bible says, the labor of the foolish weareth every one of them, because he knoweth not how to go into the city. This is the labor of the foolish weareth every one of them, because he knoweth not how to go into the city. Let me quickly explain this thing. Let me legacy a bit before I continue what we're discussing. Look at that. The labor of the foolish, say it weareth them. They keep laboring without result. That is what people are. That is what is happening to several people all over the world now. Only few people are rich. They said there's this theory of 90 and 10. Said that 10% of the population of people in the world are controlling the 90%. 90% income, 90% wealth in the world. See, we have 90% people that belongs to the world of masses. I refuse to be in that category. I refuse to be, and I refuse for you to. But we need to understand what we need to know, so that we will relocate ourselves where God wants us to be, so that we will enjoy everything God had in plan for us. God didn't create man to suffer. God did not create man to suffer. God did not create man to suffer. Let me tell you one secret before I move on. See, after you've discovered your destiny and you've discovered your purpose and you've discovered your location and you stay in there, I give you only 3 years. 3 years after your wilderness experience. I give you only 3 years before you come to land. It's a principle in the kingdom. You know, after every 3 years, every little child will grow, will start walking. So after 3 years, if you are doing something for 3 years and you are not resulting in nothing, that means something is wrong. You've missed something. How can you be in ministry for more than 15 years and nothing is happening? How can you be in a particular job for more than 15, 10 years and nothing is happening there? How can you say you are doing something for more than 5, 6, 7 years and you are not seeing good results? There's something is wrong. It's either you don't know something or you are making a particular mistake. And that is it. So I'm here to show you some of these things very quickly. See, the labor of the foolish. The labor of the foolish. God wants us to labor, definitely. That's why he created the work for man. Do you get? But who are the foolish? The foolish people are the people that doesn't know what they are supposed to know. Do you see that? See, it takes wisdom to labor wisely. Labor requires strength, tenacity, and perseverance. Look at that. It takes wisdom to labor wisely. Some people believe in hard work. Work hard. It's good to work hard, but you must work hard with what? With sense, so that you don't just waste your time on what will not yield. Do you see? You see why people increase in age and amount to nothing in life? Because they labor foolishly. Christian notwithstanding. Can you see that? Look at the city. He said, because they know it not how to go into the city. So many people don't even know the city. And that city is called their location. It's your location. Look at that. There is a location where your assignment has been assigned. This is where your voice is needed. Your effort is crowned. And your impact will be noticed. And this is where your result resides. This is where your result resides. You will remain a stranger or not until a portion of land has been accommodated unto you. Do you understand what I'm saying? You need to understand this thing. See, your protection. pretentious can never come to limelight, or else you get your own very location. You have your own God ordained territory and location where destiny will operate and bring you to global light. Where your destiny will operate and bring you to global light. I'll show you from the scriptures. Follow me. Let's get into the book of Genesis. Let's study Adam's first. In the book of Genesis, chapter 2, verse 7, is in the book. And I need you to read everything from verse 7 to 13. Let me quickly read it. And the Lord God formed Adam, the dust, breathed into his nostrils. You can read verse 2, verse 8 now says, the Lord planted a garden in the east of what? Eden. God planted a garden in the east world of Eden. And he put man where he had formed. God had created the whole world. And he even planted another garden. And he put Adam. Why didn't God just put Adam in the whole world to be laboring and be moving up and down? No. Because God had understand the principle of location. He was the one that designed it. So he put Adam where he's supposed to be. So that Eden is the headquarter where Adam will be ministering from. Do you understand? So you need to locate your own headquarter. That is from there. You will not spread your influence all over the world. I don't think you understand what I'm saying. And inside that Eden, look at where everything is. God made trees for food, fruits for food. And there's a tree of life and tree of knowledge of good and evil inside the garden too. Bible said, and a river went out of Eden to water the garden, and the river parted into four. We'll talk about this one later. Let's continue with our discussion. See? Look at that. God is a master planner. Master planner. You need to find your divine location and sit down there. Sit down there. Every provision you need, every resources you need in life and destiny is inside you and inside your Eden. I will show you God's provision for you in Eden. Do you understand what I'm saying? Number one, the four rivers. Genesis chapter 2, verse 10. Bible said, and a river went out. This is a mystery. The mystery of Eden. There is something called the mystery of Eden. Eden is a spiritual location, and it can also be a physical location. That's what I'm trying to teach you. Eden is a similitude of the presence of a Bible called Eden, the garden of the living God. God created the garden from the garden because he wanted to put a man inside, and he made sure all the resources that man will need is available in the garden. You need to locate your own Eden too. Although it's a spiritual location too, but it's also a physical. There's a physical location called Eden for your own life that can be anywhere. And you need to find it out. Let's get to the four rivers back. See? Those four rivers are eternal mysteries. The Spirit of the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Wisdom, taught me this mystery at a particular time. And I'm sharing with you. Four mysteries. Number one, the Bible said the first river is called River Pison. River Pison. The Bible says, the name of the force is Pison, that is compassing the whole land of Avila where there is gold. The meaning of Pison means the sparse, which means grow up or grow fat. Fat means worth. See, fat means worth. And the sparse means spread abroad or scatter, which is fame. So, Pison, River Pison is the secret to wealth and fame you would need in life. And it's in your location. The wealth and fame that everybody is looking for is in your home location. It's called River Pison. And this River Pison is in the land of Abida where there is gold and precious mineral resources. Look at that. Let me tell you something. This is the secret of the wealth of Arab nation, because their forefather Ismail lived in that land and died there. In the book of Genesis chapter 25 verse 18, the Bible says, and they dwelt from Abida unto Shur. That is before Egypt. As that goes to Assyria, and he died in the presence of all his brethren. Talking about Ishmael. You see the reason why the Arab nation are very wealthy, but they are the most wealthiest nation in the world. Magic them. The Arab nation, very wealthy. They are too secret to their wealth. I will teach the second one in 200 level. This is the first secret to their wealth. I will teach the second one when you get to 400 level, 200 level, I will teach. Look at that. So your wealth and your fame, the fame you are looking for up and down, is in your location. You don't need to disturb yourself. If it's meant to be looking for, God will have told us from the beginning. Everything is available. You just need to know how to position yourself and receive them. That's all. Papa Hi Adeboye is living in a redemption camp. They take forest, and everybody in the whole world is going down there to look for him. Look at Bishop Adeboye. He's in Ota. They believe that Ota is the land of witch in Yoruba. They call it Olaje, Onikabiaje Ota. Name of Aje means a witch. They have several difficult witches in Ota. And Bishop got there and he exercised dominion. And people from all over the world are watching him there, going down there. Because that is his location. No matter how strange the place is, no matter how wicked the place is, if it is your location, you will survive it and you will dominate. The second river is called the river Gihon. Gihon means to break forth. And the Bible says in the land of Crush or Ethiopia, this place was in the Mesopotamia. Do you remember Mesopotamia in the hall of Chaldeans, Abraham's leading city, where God called Abraham out from? In chapter 12. You see, and Mesopotamia at that particular time is a place, is the beginning of civilization on earth. And before any civilization will start, there must be breakthrough in science and discovery, wisdom and knowledge. Do you see that? So the second thing you will find in your land is discovery and creativity. The Lord will open your mind up to the extent that you would, even if your location is in the village, you will turn that village into a city because of that power of creativity that will come upon your mind. The third one is River Idikel. Idikel means ashore, which means going steep, which means a slope or a gradient. It means prophetically a place of oil and the anointing. Steep. It means to soak into a liquid. That liquid is called the oil, the anointing. So the power and the anointing you are looking for up and down for your work, for your purpose. See people running up and down looking for power is in your location. When you get to your location, that is the place of empowerment for your destiny. Listen to me very well. I'm giving you the word of God. The fourth one is called River Euphrates, which also means break forth or crushing. You see, the infamous city of Babylon sits majestically astride this formidable river. Remember that Babylon was the ruler of the world at its time. Very powerful kingdom. It became an antichrist kingdom. You see Babylon all over the scriptures, even in Revelation. It means, the meaning of Babylon means dominion and power to reign. So, in your location, you will find power, dominion, and power to reign. Because God had given us the mandate of dominion to rule and reign in our world. And you will find all of these things in your location. So why are people suffering? Because they don't know these things. See, let me give you. There are several other provisions that is being made available in your location. The second one is, you see, the tree of knowledge and the tree of life. This one is a very deep mystery too, but I explained it in a particular poem. I pasted the poem in the book too. Get the book and read the book. You'll find it there. I won't talk about that in the audio because of our time. And the third one you'll find in your location, the third thing you'll find in your location is instruction. Instruction. What to do and what not to do. After God had placed Adam in the location, what did God do? God gave him what? Instruction. What to do. Till, cultivate. What not to do. Do not eat this particular fruit. So, the reason why you are not hearing instruction continually from God is because you are not in your location. When you are in your location, God will be speaking to you from time to time. Look at Abraham. Abraham was in where God put him. And God kept talking to him. God kept talking to him. God kept talking to him. And that is how it's supposed to be. Bringing your assignment, every page of your life and destiny. But if you are not in your location, you won't hear God at all. So, I need us to prove, the Bible says, from the mouth of two or three witnesses, the truth will be established. So, if what we just discussed, the mystery, I said the Holy Spirit taught me, is true, we will prove it again from the scriptures. Let me prove it. There are several scriptures I would love to prove it from you, but there's no time. Book of Isaiah chapter 53, verse 2. Let me talk about it too. But then, let's leave that. But let's look at the life of Isaac. In the book of Genesis chapter 26, the Bible says there was famine in the land, and Isaac wanted to go unto Egypt, and God appeared to Isaac and said, no, don't go to Egypt, stay in Gerar.
The Bible says, and Isaac dwelt in Gerar. Look at that. There was famine in the land, though. Like, there's famine all over the world. Now, everybody's looking for greener pastures. Don't look for any greener pasture anywhere. Your greener pasture, I told you, is you to go and pray and ask from God. Where do you want me to be? Where is my location at this particular moment of my life? And sit down there. You get? The Bible said, and Isaac sold into the land, and he reaped 100-fold. Let me quickly see if what we said is true. The four mysteries. Number one, we said the mystery of wealth and fame. It's in your location. Look at that. The Bible said, and Isaac become great and wealthy. Become great and wealthy. Become famous. Because he dwelt in Gerar. Look at that. The second one is discovery and creativity. The Bible says, and Isaac began to dig wells. There was farming in the land. There was no way plants could grow. But God gave Isaac an invention of irrigation farming. He was the inventor of irrigation farming. So he started digging well. He dug well. They would cover it. And he found a well. And he called his well Rehoboth, because the Lord had what? Enlarged me. Look at that. That's creativity. It flows to Isaac in his location. The third one is what? The anointing. How could somebody sow a part one maize and reap 100 maize? That's too much to be natural. That's the power of the Holy Ghost, the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Look at the third one, Asher, the place of the anointing, the river of anointing. Look at that. And that is the anointing of God working in the life of Isaac, because he stayed where God wanted him to be. The fourth one that I explained was what? Dominion and power to rule. Look at this one. And Isaac became so great that the two nations were heavy. Somebody to be very wealthy, that countries, to be heavy one man. They were jealous of the blessing of God upon his life. It was their ruler. To the extent that they were begging him for resources. They were begging for him. And he's in a strange land. And he was still the ruler there. That is what God wants us to be. If it is America, God wants you to be. Go there. If it is Nigeria, if it is China, if it is deep Africans, Kenya, and anywhere, go there. If it's in mission field, villages, go there. That is where the provision of God for your life is. Don't run up and down. See, some people receive a ticket out of relevance in their life because they travel out of the country. People think traveling that is the way to wealth and prosperity. No. The devil can give you a visa to ruin your destiny. There are several thousands, if not tens and hundreds of thousands of Nigerians and Africans that has lives in all of the European countries. Are they looking for? Everything a man needs, God is the creator of heaven and earth. Everything a man needs is inside the man and is in his location. And you need to look for your location. Get the ebook, finish up the rest. Let me pray for you. Father, we thank you for your word. Thank you for bringing your word to your people. Thank you for this word will change their lives forever. Father, I pray for your people that their lives are changed as this word is entering into their spirit. Their lives are changed forever in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your spirit rest upon them. Let your power rest upon them. Let your grace rest upon them in the name of Jesus. As we discover our location and discover where we are supposed to dwell and minister the purpose that you have given unto us and have influence all across the nations of the world. Father, Lord, help us, Lord. Give us grace. Give us strength to abide and stay inside the place in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we are free. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
We believe you've been blessed by this teaching of wisdom. For more inquiries, contact us on Facebook and other social media platforms as Eleazer School of Destiny. God bless you. Amen.